वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, दिस इज द लेक्चर ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग यूजिंग सी प्लस प्लस। वी हैव कंप्लीटेड अवर फर्स्ट यूनिट, दैट इज प्रिंसिपल्स ऑफ ऑब्जेक्ट ओरिएंटेड प्रोग्रामिंग। फ्रॉम दिस सेशन वी विल स्टार्ट अवर सेकेंड यूनिट, दैट इज क्लासेस एंड ऑब्जेक्ट्स। दिस यूनिट हैज द 18 मार्क्स। सो बिफोर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द एक्चुअल यूनिट, फर्स्ट वी विल सी द CO, दैट इज कोर्स आउटकम, विच इज रिलेटेड टू दिस यूनिट, दैट इज डेवलप सी प्लस प्लस प्रोग्राम्स यूजिंग क्लासेस एंड ऑब्जेक्ट्स। मीन्स आफ्टर कंप्लीशन ऑफ दिस यूनिट यू कैन एबल टू डेवलप सी प्लस प्लस प्रोग्राम्स using classes and object. In C language there is no concept like classes and object because that is a procedure oriented language. But in CPP, that is a object oriented language, the main concept is classes and object. So after completion of this unit you can easily develop the C++ program. Again we will see the learning objectives. The first is to understand concept of classes and objects, to learn concept of objects, to study concept of constructors and types of constructors, and to understand the concept of destruct. Means under this unit we will learn these things. Now the first point, that is introduction of the unit. So a class is a way that binds data and functions that operate on the data together in a single unit. Means in class there are two main elements, that is data and functions. And function means what? That function operate on the data. The classes and objects are the most important concept in C++. Classes serve as a blueprint or template that provides a layout common to all of its instances known as objects. Class is a user defined data type which hold its own data members and member function which can be accessed and used by creating instance, that is object of that class. So see here, C++ is a object oriented language. So classes and objects are the most important concept in a C++. So class is serve as a blueprint or template. Means what? When we going to create objects are the instance of a class. And again see here, class is a user defined data type. Why it is called as a user defined data type? Because in class the user going to create the data members and member function. Means you here user is going to define how many data members will be present in class and how many data or member functions are will be present in a class. So it is a user defined function. Here user is going to write the data members and member function in the class. So it is called as a user defined data type. Next we will see the specifying a class. So a class in C++ is a user defined data type that binds data and functions that operate on the data together in a single unit. Like other user defined data types in C++, it also need to be defined before using its object in the program. Means suppose if you want to use object of that class, before going to use that object we have to define that class. Okay, a class definition in C++ specify a new data type that can be treated as a built-in data type. So generally class specification has following two parts. So which are the main, the two main parts? First, the class declaration describes the type scope of its member, and the class function definitions describe how the class functions are implemented. So these are the two, data members and member function, that is functions, are the main two parts of the class. Now we will see the declaration of a class. So how to declare a class? The keyword class is used to declare a class in C++. The declaration of a class always ends with the semicolon. All data members and member function are declared within the bracket braces, which are called the body of a class. So how to declare a class? See here, this is the syntax. Class, that is a keyword. Here we can write the class name. Class name is also identifier, so we cannot use the reserved data type or keywords for the class name. Here private, variable declaration, function declaration, then public, variable declaration and function declaration. So here private and public are the visibility modes or accessibility modes. Variable declaration and function declaration, either this way we can declare variable as privately or publicly, and this is called as a body of a class. That is a, this part is known as the body of a class. So see here again, class keyword, then class name, open bracket. Here we can declare the variable and function privately or public or protected, and at the end of the class declaration we have to put the semicolon. This is the declaration of class. Now the class specifies type and scope of its members. The keyword class indicates that the class name. So see here, class specifies type and scope of its member. Means suppose if we are declaring variable here, means what? This variable is declared privately, and if we are going to declare the variable in public session, means this variable is publicly used. The body of a class is enclosed within the curly bracket followed by the semicolon. So this is the body of a class, which is written in a curly bracket and end with the semicolon. The body of a class contains declaration of variables and functions, collectively known as data members. Means variable declared in a class is known as the data members, and functions which are declared in the function is declared in the class is known as the member functions. The keyword private, public and protected are known as the access specifier. Also we can call it visibility modes. They are also known as visibility modes or accessibility modes. Each member of a class is associated with an access specifier. Means these variable declaration and function, these variables and functions are related to this public, and these variable and functions are related to the private accessibility mode. Now we will see the example. See here, class is a keyword, student is a class name. Here we can write any name, we can give any name to the class which is follow the rule of identifier in a C++. Now in curly bracket, here integer roll number and character name. So these two are the data members. Here public access modifier, void get data and void display. These two are the member functions. Okay, because it is declared into the class declaration. So void get data, the definition of this function is roll number equal to 10, name is equal to Omkar. And now we are use the display function to display the roll number and name of that student. That is cout roll number, here the value of roll number, that is 10, will be printed, and name, here the name of the student will be printed. Here end of the class, and it end with the semicolon. Here a class called student contains two data members, that is roll number and name. These are the data members because these are the variables declared in the class, and two member functions, that is get data and display. These two are the member functions. The data members are privately by default, whereas both the members functions are public. Here see here, these variables are declared here, but here no any access modifier is written. So it is by default private. If no any access specifier is written in the class, then it is by default private. So these roll number and name are by default private, and this get function, sorry, get data and display, these two functions are publicly defined. So these member functions are public and these two data members are private in this example. Now we will see program for a class. See here, IOStream, that is header file is included. After that, class square. Here square is a name of class. In public session, that is access modifier, we are written integer area, integer side. Here the function name, that is member function name, is a area, and here we are passing side argument from the function a equal to side into side. So how we can calculate the square? That is side into side, and return a. After multiplying this side, it will store the result into a, and this a is returned to this area function. Now void show, the area is the value or square is stored into the a, so the area is variable a. Now private integer side and a means this side and a integer variables are privately defined. So it is not necessary to declare variable first after that declaring the function. We can declare function first and after that we can declare the variables, that is data members. And here closing bracket x semicolon. Now what is that x? X is the object of this square class. So here at the time of declaration of class, we are creating the object. Now integer main. Here square is a class name and x is a what? Object. So x dot area means object dot area, and we are passing here value 10. So integer side is 10. Now 10 into 10 is 100. Now this a contains 100 value. X dot show, it will call the show function. The area is 100 and return 0. Now see here the output, the area is 100. Why 100? Because here we are passing the value 10. Now after calling this area function, our program flow goes here into the area function, and after that, that side variable has the value 10. So 10 into 10 is 100. So here result is displaying the area is 100. This is the simple program for the class. Now what is object, or how to create objects? An object is an instance occurrence of a class. A class provides blueprints for the object. An object is a variable of type class. Means see, when we declare any variable like integer a, in that what is a? A is a variable of integer. Okay, same like that, an object is a variable of class. Means class is a user defined data type. In that we can define the data members and member functions. And when we create any object of that class, means automatically the data members and member functions are related to that object. Once a class is defined, we can declare variables of that type. Means if we want to create object, first we have to declare the class. After declaring class, we can create any number of object of that class. In C++, a class variable is called as a class object or class instance. When we create an object of a class, see here, when we create object of a class, what will happen? The memory is allocated, constructor is called implicitly, and memory gets initialized. Means when we create any object of a class, first the memory is allocated to that object. After that, constructor is called implicitly. So what is constructor? We will see next into this unit. Memory gets initialized. The process of creating object is called class initialization. Okay, class initialization means what? Creating object is known as the class initialization. We can create object as using following syntax. So, how to create object? First, we have to write the class name and after that object name. Here again, object name is a identifier. We can declare number of object in a single statement like class name object 1 comma object 2 like object n. That object names are separated by the comma. So just like a basic data type variable integer a comma b comma c, we can create number of object like class name object 1 comma object 2 and so on. See here example student s. Here s is a single object of that class student, and student s1 s2, here s1 and s2 are the two objects of the student. So more than one object of a class student, these are the object of the class student. The another way is we can create object by placing their name immediately after the class declaration. Means suppose if we declare the class, and after that in the main function we can declare the or we can create the object of that class like using this syntax, that is class name object 1 2 and so on. But also we can declare the or we can create the object at the time of class declaration. Means here class student, this is the body of the class, and at the end the close curly bracket, after that we can write the object of that class, name of the object, that is s1 and s2, and then semicolon. Now this s1 and s2 are the object of this class student. We can directly put here semicolon, and we can create this object into the main class, that is student s1 comma s2 semicolon. This is also a valid syntax, and here after immediately after the class declaration we can create the object of that class. Now in our above example we create the object s1 and s2 of class student. Once the object of class is created, object can access the member of class using the member access operator, that is dot operator. Means after creating the object, suppose here s1 and s2 are the object of class student, and in that class student our member data member is suppose integer roll number. So if you want to access that roll number, that is data member, after creating the object by using the dot operator we can access the data member, that is s1 dot roll number, s2 dot roll number. So the syntax for accessing class members through object is given below. To access data members we use the following syntax, that is object name dot variable name. Here to access member functions we use the object name dot member function name and actual argument list. Here if you want to access the data members or member function, we must use the dot operator. So see the here the example, if emp is a object of class employee, then we can write employee emp, that is class is a employee and object is a emp. And now emp.eno, that is object name emp, and eno is a employee number and it is a data member of employee class. So eno should be public data member. Now student s.getData. Here s is the object of class student and getData is a member function of student class. So by using the dot operator here and here we can access the data members and member functions of the class. Now we will see the program demonstrate a class or a simple class. So see here we are including the iostream and cmath function into this program. See here class circle. Here circle is a class name, class is a keyword. So here in the circle class we are privately defined one data member, that is float radius. Radius is a variable having float data type. Now here we are defining the member function, that is void set radius float r, Here we are passing the value, that is float r. Now radius equal to r. Radius is a private data member and we are assigning this value to the radius. After that float find area. Here we are going to find the area of the circle. So return 3.14 into power of radius comma 2. So what is the formula of calculating area of circle? That is a pi r square. So power is a inbuilt function, that is it will multiply the radius into 2 times, that is square of radius. So 3.14 into radius square, it will give us area of the circle. Now in integer main circle sphere 1 sphere 2. Now this sphere 1 and sphere 2, these two are the object of class circle. Now sphere 1 dot set radius 1. Here after calling this set radius function, this program flow goes here. Now the value of float r is 1. Now this 1 is passed to the radius equal to r. Now value of radius is 1 and here 3.14 into 1 square, that is 1. 3.14 into 1 is a 3.14. So here the value of or area of the sphere is 3.14. Now second sphere 2, the second object is sphere 2 dot set radius and here we are passing the 2.5 value to this r. Now this 2.4 is assigned to the radius. Now 3.14 into 2.5 into 2.5, that is 19.625. This is the sphere 1 and this is the sphere 2. Just remember here the name of class is circle. In the circle class we have declaring one private data member and two public member functions. After writing the definition of function, where or we can write the integer main, in that we have to create the objects, that is circle is a class name, and after that these two are the objects, sphere 1 and sphere 2. Now if you want to access this, what if you want to access this member functions, we have to use the dot operator. So sphere 1, that is object 1 dot set radius, and sphere 2 dot set radius. Now displaying the value of area, the area of sphere is sphere dot find area. Now after calling this sphere dot find area function, the program flow comes here. Now 3.14 into the radius 1 into 1 is a 3.14. Now it is displaying the answer 3.14. And second, the area of sphere 2 is sphere 2 dot find area, that is a 2.5 is passed here, and 3.14 into 2.5 into 2.5, that is 19.625. This is the simple program of a class. Now see here the important part, that is access specifiers. So access specifiers are used to restrict limits the accessibility of class members. Access specifiers depends how the members of the class can be accessed. Means see here, when we declare class, in that we can define the data members and member function, and we can define data members and member functions by using the access specifiers. So what is the access specifier? It is used to restrict the limits. Means suppose if we are declaring the variable private, means it has the limited scope. If we are declaring the variable publicly, then it has the, we can use that variable outside the class also. So each member of a class is associated with an access specifier. In the class declaration syntax, the keyword private, public and protected are known as the access specifiers, also known as the visibility modes. So when a member is declared private, see this is very important, when a member is declared private, It can be accessed only inside the class, while a public member is accessible both inside and outside the class. And protected members are accessible both inside the class in which they are declared as well as inside the derived class of the same class. See here, if we declare member as a private, then it can be accessed only inside the class. Means if we define any, or we can declare any member, data member or member function in privately, then we can use it only inside the class, not outside of that class. If we declare variable or functions using the public access specifier, then it is accessible for both inside and outside of the class. And if we define the member as a protected, then we can access these members inside the class, okay, where it is declared, and inside the derived class, means the class which is derived from that class, we can use the protected members. Once an access specifier has been used, it remains in effect until another access specifier is encountered or the end of the class declaration is reached. Means when we write private access specifier, and after that we can define the or declare the variable and function, until the public access specifier is not written into the program, these all variables and functions should remain the private. An access specifier is provided by writing the appropriate keyword, that is private or public or protected, followed by a colon, means private colon, public colon. Now see here, the default access specifier of the member of a class is private. So default is a private. If we are not written any access specifier while declaring the variables and member functions into the class, it by default the private. If no access specifier is provided in the class definition, the access specifier is considered to be private. General format, see here the syntax. So class, class name, here private and colon, declaration of private members appears here, like private data members or private member functions. And here public semicolon, public colon, here we are declaring the public data members and member function. Same like protected protected colon, we can declare the member functions or data members. See here the example. Here class book, book is a class. Now private by default. Here we are not using the private keyword with the colon, but directly we are writing the character, title and float price. These both variables are by default private. Now public, get data, void, put data. These are the functions which are declared the publicly. In above example, a class named book with the two data member, that is title and price, and two member function, that is get data and put data, is created. The member functions are declared as public. It implies that the data members are accessible only through the member function. Means this title and price are used or accessible only for the get and put member function, not for the other functions which are declared outside the class, while the member function can be accessed anywhere in the program. So get data and put data, these are the public functions, so we can use anywhere in the program. So this is the today's session. In that we have covered the class. So what is class, the declaration of class, what is object, declaration of object, and access specifier. So see here, you have to write assignment. I will give questions. That is, first define class and object. So here you have to write the definition of class and definition of object. Now write the syntax to declare the class with example. This is the second question. And third, explain accessibility modes or access specifiers in C++. These are the three questions on today's session. You have to write assignment in your assignment notebook.